Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Monday said in Rajya Sabha that people's hearts can be won by political parties even without rushing to the well of the House to register their protest on various issues. Speaking in the House during a special discussion marking 250 sessions of Rajya Sabha, he said that the NCP and BJD have always adhered to parliamentary norms, something even his party, the BJP, could learn from.
Do dalon ka aaj main ullekh karna chahunga, ek NCP aur dusra BJD. और किसी का नाम छूट जाए तो मुझे क्षमा करना, लेकिन मैं दो का उल्लेख कर रहा हूं। इन दोनों दलों की विशेषता देखिए, उन्होंने खुद ने डिसिप्लिन तय किया है कि हम वेल में नहीं जाएंगे, और मैं देख रहा हूं एक बार भी उन्होंने एक भी सदस्य ने नियम को तोड़ा नहीं है। हम सभी राजनीतिक दलों को सीखना होगा, इंक्लूडिंग माई पार्टी।
Speaking at the historic 250th session of the Rajya Sabha, Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Monday said Rajya Sabha is the soul of India's federal structure. He also said that the Rajya Sabha has time and again made a strong contribution to national good by coming together to pass landmark bills.
Yahi sadan hai jisne teen talaq ka kanoon hoga ki nahi hoga, har ek ko lagta tha yahi par atak jayega, lekin isi sadan ki maturity hai कि उसने एक बहुत बड़ा महत्वपूर्ण वुमेन एम्पावरमेंट का काम इसी सदन में किया। ये गर्व की बात है कि इसी सदन ने सामान्य वर्ग के गरीब परिवार का 10% आरक्षण का निर्णय किया, लेकिन देश में कहीं तनाव नहीं हुआ, विरोध भाव पैदा नहीं हुआ, सहमति का भाव बना। वन नेशन वन टैक्स सिस्टम की ओर इसी सदन ने सर्वसम्मति बना करके देश को दिशा देने का काम किया है, और उसी के कारण एक नए विश्वास के साथ विश्व में हम अपनी बात रख पा रहे हैं। इसी सदन में 1964 में जो वादे किए गए थे कि एक साल के भीतर भीतर इस काम को कर दिया जाएगा, जो नहीं हो पाया था वो धारा 370 और 35A, इसी सदन और देश को दिशा देने का काम इस सदन ने पहले किया, बाद में लोकसभा ने किया।
Former Prime Minister Manmohan Singh has said India's economic slowdown is the result of profound fear and distrust among people who act as agents of economic growth. Writing for the Hindu newspaper, the noted economist said, "Tearing of our social fabric of trust is the fountainhead of our current economic malaise." The two-time former Prime Minister blamed the Modi government for what he called rupturing the country's social fabric through malified, until proven otherwise, doctrine of governance, citing that the GDP growth is at a 15-year low, unemployment is at a 45-year high, and bad loans are at an all-time high. He wrote, "These are manifestations of a deeper underlying malaise that plagues the nation's economy today."
Students from the Jawaharlal Nehru University and police clashed at Delhi's Ber Sarai after their march to parliament was stopped by the police. The JNU Students Union has gone ahead with its silent march to parliament despite Section 144 being imposed around the campus and parliament. There is already police deployment in both areas. The varsity students have been protesting for nearly 3 weeks against the draft hostel manual, which has provisions for hostel fee hike, dress code and curfew timings. Meanwhile, the HRD Ministry on Monday appointed a 3-member committee to recommend ways to restore normal functioning of the Jawaharlal Nehru University. The HRD Ministry's committee will initiate dialogues with students and administration, as well as submit recommendations on resolution of all issues.
Agra may be speeding towards a rechristening. According to reports, the Yogi Adityanath government is planning to change the name of Agra district to Agravan. The state government has also asked the Ambedkar University to look into the circumstances and time when Agravan's name was changed to Agra. The proposal follows the Uttar Pradesh government's earlier move to rename Allahabad to Prayagraj and Mughalsarai railway station to Deen Dayal Upadhyay.
Shares of Reliance Communications on Monday touched their 52-week low of 57 paise after the company's chairman, Anil Dhirubhai Ambani, along with four directors, resigned from the company. Chaya Virani, Raina Karani, Manjari Kakkar and Suresh Rangachar are the four directors who have tendered their resignation, according to a company release. On Friday, Reliance Communications reported a consolidated net loss of 30,158 crore rupees for Q2. Shares of other Anil Dhirubhai Ambani group companies also fell on the news.
A sanitation worker in Pune, Mahadev Jadhav, is gaining popularity for his unique initiative. Jadhav spreads awareness about cleanliness by composing and singing songs. Some of his tunes are remixes of popular Bollywood songs. He's been working with the Pune Municipal Corporation for the last 25 years and alerts people to keep their surroundings clean while doing his daily chores. An MBA student in Indore has an innovative way of managing the traffic and raising awareness about traffic rules and regulations. Shubhi Jain uses her peculiar dance moves to urge people to wear their helmets and seat belts while driving. She's been managing traffic in Indore for the last 15 days and was motivated to become a traffic volunteer after the many road accidents she witnessed.